You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. Today, we've got an exciting matchup on tap. It's the Eagles coming in at 5-0, going up against the Texans, who come in at 4-2. With that, let's get out to Lincoln Financial Field. Here are Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
Okay, Larry, thank you. We are just off I-95 at the home of the Eagles, Lincoln Financial Field on the south side of Philadelphia. Today, we've got a matchup here in pivotal week 7. And the decision to bring it out proved somewhat fruitful as he is able to get it across the 25 by a little bit. Between the Houston Texans and the Philadelphia Eagles. Across the 20 to the 24-yard line. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's 2nd and 2. Yeah, yeah. 2nd down following the run. The 27-yard line. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
Not too many more ideal situations in 2nd and 2 in order to try and pick up a first down. They ran it and picked it up.
Denver.
Now the offense lining up 1st and 10.
King Hayes, can you hear me?
Set! Green 39! Green 39!
On 1st and 10, here's Wentz. This one brought in by
Dwayne. Y'all hear me?
And he takes this one just shy of midfield on the way to the 49. They practiced this all week. Pretty clear it paid off there. Threw it downfield, made it look relatively easy.
It always comes a little bit easier. Practiced it and tuned things up, and you're confident in what you're doing now. They felt very, very good about their plan, and we saw the execution because the confidence of the players was there.
All right, here we go. Green!
Wentz now on 1st down. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete. Isaiah Crowell, the intended target, and that'll bring up 2nd down. And the big boys up front in the trenches. What do you think of the O-line, Charles?
I love them because this is a group that's so cohesive. They know what the man next to them is going to do at all times, and they operate as a terrific unit.
So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. 2nd down and 10.
Over! All right, here we go. Green 39.
On play action, it's Wentz. And incomplete there. A nice hit jars the ball free and brings up 3rd down. Now Wentz on 3rd down. And able to complete it to Green Beckham. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. Now the Texans are going to stop it as they signal for a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And here comes play number 6 on this drive.
Watch left. Let's go.
3-19. On 1st down, Wentz. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up 2nd down. Really good defensive effort. They were all over that little swing pass out to the right side, but for loss yarded.
Terrific read. Better execution and done with a lot of enthusiasm, wasn't it?
Absolutely.
They saw it all the way, ran to the football, and caused a nice play for lost yardage.
Again, they'll throw with Wentz. And complete to Zach Ertz.
What the fuck?
And they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the 25.
Almost not fair. The big guy running the corner route, being able to lean and push and get to where he wants.
So how do you stop it?
A lot of times you want to have a linebacker on him, a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well because his quickness often wins the route.
Second So here we go, first and 10 now.
Strong right, strong right. Hey, watch the slant, watch the slant. Set, Green, 39.
Now the first carry for Matt Jones. And he'll get a couple here down to the 22.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively.
Here we go now. Watch it now, Barney. Barney.
They keep it on the ground. This time it's Crowell. And they'll get him down right about the 20. Give him three on the run there. Now they're looking at a third and about 5.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
To throw, it's Wentz. And this is Ertz with it, right side. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defense side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. You're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
A long drive here, play 12 coming up for the offense.
4 down, 4 down, check, 4 down, 4 down.
No, check, Patriot, Patriot.
They'll run it again with Crowell. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and it'll bring up a 3rd down.
So if I'm an offensive coordinator, there's one thing that I know for sure. This is one of the top 5 teams in the NFL against the run. So when I look at my playlist, I'm probably thinking about throwing it.
All right, T, let's go. All right, T. All right, here we go. 3-19.
From the gun on 3rd down, Wentz. And that is incomplete. Jordan Matthews, the one he was looking for. And now it's 4th down. Now they've got to be a little frustrated here to not complete that on 3rd down after having such a long drive going.
Hey, you're talking about going over 70 yards on the drive. Yeah, did you say a little frustrated?
Very frustrated.
Yeah, I'm with you on that. Very frustrated. There's no doubt about it. They thought they were going to have a chance to cash in the end zone. Now it looks like it's likely a field goal attempt.
And Sturgis able to knock it through. And the Eagles, they take a 3-0 lead. So a 15-play drive. Can't believe that only resulted in 3, but it did.
That is somewhat amazing, isn't it? When you hold the ball that long, run offense that well, yet only put 3 points on the board, it has to be a little bit of a disappointment, doesn't it?
Has to. Receiver. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And Miller with it over the middle. The completion good for 3, and it's 2nd down. And this O-line, it is the lifeblood of the offense.
They established the tone. Mean, nasty, physical. They can't wait to get after people. That allows the rest of the offense to feel confident.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a 3rd down and 6. And the defense now for the Eagles.
Timmy Jernigan, play him over the nose, play him a defensive tackle, bounce him out to defensive end. Wherever you want to put him, Timmy Jernigan can play.
Offense faces a 3rd and medium with 6 yards left.
Gone, gone,
back to
go.
Slam, slam.
Back to throw here.
Looking for Gronkowski, and he's got him. Vamos a coger ya. They get 14 yards there at a first down.
And the game just keeps evolving. Big guys running those corner routes, so difficult to cover.
Double tight, guys, double tight.
It's complete to Fuller. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
Not gonna happen today. All day.
Woo, get it. He ain't going nowhere. Woo, he ain't going nowhere.
Second down now after the pass completion.
Watch tight end. Gone.
Clifford. Set. Green 39. Green 39. Gone. Gone.
Alert three.
All right, now look at 56.
Shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. On the right side, this is Miller. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. Well, we saw the practice film this week. They wanted to focus on these intermediate passing plays, and it paid off there.
And they took that focus not just to the practice field, but in the film room to show the guys exactly what they wanted, what types of looks they should expect to get, and how they would beat those coverages each and every time. And it paid off on that play.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and it's Texans football as we get going at quarter number two, but they face a second and long to start things out. Scrimmage and taken down. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
Partner, how many times do we talk to people before a game and they talk about how toughness is going to win? But we just saw it on that play. Six defensive backs in the game. They're dime package. They run the draw with all these big people coming downfield. We found a way to get in there, an undersized defense, and win that play.
A bullet throw, but incomplete. Will Fuller was the intended target, and that'll bring up a fourth down. Fourth down, so on is the punter, Riley Dixon. Now this is fielded in the end zone. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the Eagles will be backed up deep to get the drive started as they take over first and 10. Here comes Eagle offense now as they get set to take over here. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Oh, so close to an interception. Read that beautifully. Got his hands on it, couldn't get it, and it's second down.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play, and guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
Blue 90!
Wentz will try again on second down. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and, of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
Let's go. 319. All right, now look at 56. All right, now look at 56. Let's go.
Now a first down carry by Jones. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Nothing on that one. It'll be second down. So nothing there, but maybe you blame that on the blocking.
Yeah, at some point, you've got to win at the point of attack. And on that play, that was all the defense. They made it happen.
Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10.
Hey, hey, hey. You got three.
They'll come out in the pistol.
319. 319.
Now Wentz throwing on second down. The ball popped in the air and intercepted. Picked off by the former first-round pick, Kevin Johnson. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line. And the Texans set to come onto the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now,
here we go.
With the
Green,
game
39.
This close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
Well, they held them to a short gain on that one, and it almost felt like on that first
run,
they're trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop the jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Give them 12 yards on that one. It earns them a fresh set of downs.
But we just saw him run the football really effectively there with three tight ends in the game. And any defensive coordinator, when they see that set, if they can get more bodies out onto the field, not more than 11, of course, but bigger bodies to combat what they're going to do, because that's a run-heavy formation. Those guys are out there to block 9 times out of 10, and in this case, they did it really successfully.
Give them 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Look pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
And on the ground they go with a running back. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Partner, we're into the second quarter, and I guess you can kind of look at it both ways. The offense, they've got to figure out what they're going to do because they haven't scored any points. But if you're the defense, you're feeling great about what you got going on. The only concern you have to get to the half. What adjustments will the offense make to try to defeat you?
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 7 yards on the carry. Make it 3rd and 4 coming up.
On a 2nd and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long-distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on 3rd down.
And the Eagles with a dime look. 6 DBs on 3rd down. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a 4th down.
After watching that play and result, I go back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator, Brandon, before the game and said, how are you going to move the ball running it against the number 1 defense? He gave us no indication, didn't tip his hand at all, so we have to see how this unfolds as this game moves along.
So the drive takes him inside the 10, but it ends with just 3.
And a nice job defensively to rise up and make sure they didn't get in.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 20.
Hey, come cover up this vent. I'm cold.
The Eagles coming out as they get ready. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Give them a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
And they still need 8 yards for the first here on 2nd down.
3 down, 3 down. Here we go now.
On 2nd down, here's Wentz. And the reception made by Alshon Jeffery. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. Fresh set of downs here. They come out with 1 back and 3 tight ends. They go play action here on first down. Ertz has it left side. And he's going to be out of bounds, but able to take it inside the 40-yard line.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? And it sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. So a pause here for us as well. Time to pay some bills. We'll come back to Philadelphia after this.
Watch it now, Barney! Barney! Hurry up, here we go! Blue landing!
They'll run it with Jones. Shrugs the tackle.
Nice.
And he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
A one-yard gain can look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of one-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional one-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
Green, 39.
Wentz to throw on second down. Caught by the tight end Ertz.
Are you fucking kidding me, man?
Down inside the 20 at the 15. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Three down, three down.
All right, here we go. 3-19. 3-19.
Get wide.
Go on, got you now, Barney. Barney.
All right, here we go. Again, we'll see the pistol here. Now a play fake here on first down. Trey Burton, the one he was looking for. That'll bring up second down.
While we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore, I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion, and both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering where it's going to go, good or bad for your team.
3-19!
Motion!
Gone!
On second down, here's Crowell. And he'll fight his way down right around. And now the Texans want to call another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Here's play number 7 on the drive. This is 3rd and 7.
All day, just like that. Just like that.
All right, here we go.
51 to Mike. Now Wentz on third down. And he is into the
end zone.
Touchdown, Philadelphia. Alshon Jeffrey, his 3rd touchdown now on the year. And the Eagles have taken the lead. And it is up. And it's good. That'll make our score 10-3 now. Now after the touchdown, it's Sturgis to send it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. And now out comes Houston. And they had 3 points last time. But they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points?
The kicker.
Exactly. Put it through the post. That's going to help him in contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
They helped him in contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. Caught right side, it's Snead. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. They give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains. And now they're in the hurry up. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Now they set up the screen, that's complete. Only 3 there on the screen, it's 2nd down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. It's complete to Fuller. And he'll take this one in for a Texans touchdown. Will Fuller, as the first half is winding down. And the Texans are an extra point away from tying this football game. And he'll put it through, and that evens us up at 10 apiece. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Watch left.
They isolate Jeffrey to the left side.
Hurry up, here we go. Boom.
On first and 10, here's Wentz. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
Good night, baby. Good night, baby.
And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So they almost turn it over there. Scary moment. Second down here.
Single, single.
All right, here we go.
Three. Leopard. Knock, knock, Philly. Here we go.
The final shot before half for Wentz. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. We have, never mind, Larry, forget your halftime report. Apparently, we are set for the third quarter of action already. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And now out comes Houston. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half.
Detroit!
What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get them out in the flat, and let them have a chance to make people miss an open field.
And Miller with it over the middle. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. It's a pickup of six and good enough to move the chains.
Love the call by the offensive coordinator, recognizing the situation very well, calling for the play-action pass, and completing it.
319! 319!
They go play action here on first down. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
And he's across the 40, three extra yards to the 43. Call it a gain of four, and it'll leave him with a third down and six to go.
Well, so far, this game has gone the way the defensive coordinator had hoped. They've dictated things, and they've not let him run the ball very well at all. They gave up a nice game there. I doubt it'll back off their confidence. They played so well throughout this entire game.
Here we go now.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. On the right side, this is Miller. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. And in their own territory, needing only a few inches, they're going to line up to go for this thing on fourth down. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And this is caught. It's pulled in by Gronkowski. I don't know if I agree with that. I guess they don't care if I agree with that. But Boy, you have to be surprised by that, right?
I definitely was surprised that they decided to go for it in this situation. But they must have either felt like they either had a great play going on, or they're trying to show extreme confidence.
And there just continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
Now back to throw. Open man left side is Gronkowski. And he's brought down. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Let's go! 3-19!
They give it to him right up the gut. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up.
And now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. So the offense looking at a second and eight.
Check, Patriot!
Hurry up,
here we go. Philly,
Green,
here we go.
39!
Green, 39!
And they'll go with a ground attack here. Works his way inside the 30 on a pickup of four.
No, that wasn't an explosive run. That wasn't one that took it all the way to the house. But, boy, for a team that's had trouble running it the entire game, that's the kind of run they need, hopefully, to get themselves kick-started. And on third and three, they decided to go with a dime package. Six DBs.
Yeah, you're right. They've got six out there. They'll set up to throw toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down inbounds, toe-tapping, and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
And now for the offense, this is play number 11 here on this drive.
Let's go! Check! Patriot!
On first down, he'll drop to throw. And to the left side, Fedorowicz has it. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackle to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
Back 99, Philly, here we go.
And they'll go on the ground. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it leads to a first and goal.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
And this seemingly endless drive continues.
Now let's go!
Texans touchdown. A great play there. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Texans have broken the tie. Santos now to add the PAT. He's got it as they go up by a total of 17-10. Now after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. So here are the Eagles now as they get set for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10. Kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, to something to get you off to a quick start.
And Matthews over the middle with a grab. It goes as a pickup of 23. And it'll be first down, Eagles. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
Jeffrey with a catch left side. A gain of 6 there on first.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. Take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass.
Hurry up, here we go. 3-19. 3-19.
They keep it with Crowell on first. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
It's been a struggle this entire game trying to move the ball on the ground. But every now and then, you find a little chink in the armor, and that type of run right there lets them know that they can't stop every single run for almost no gain.
6 yards to go here on second down.
Double tight, guys, double tight.
Now Wentz throwing on second down. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. A gain of 4 on the play. And that's going to lead to a third down.
I'm going to show my age here a little bit. We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting like you're so old. You're only 65.
All right, here we go.
Wentz looking to throw on third and 2. And he hits his man, Matthews. And he will have a first down at about the 21-yard line. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, the receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree. One thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's the Eagles behind on the scoreboard, but with the football here as we start the 4th quarter. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. Another pistol look here. Wentz to throw on 2nd down. And this is Ertz with it, right side. Give him 7 on the play, and that's going to make it 3rd down and less than a yard.
And there's a completion to the tight end, and look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. And that's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
39.
It's a sneak. It's Wentz. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
I don't know about you, but I like this call. 3rd and inches, and instead of worrying about getting it back to a running back and maybe there's some penetration from the defensive front, just go ahead and take it, move forward, and pick up the 1st down.
And as we say often, shows confidence in your offensive
Detroit.
Line.
Detroit!
Check 49. Check 49.
All right, here we go.
Now this time, Wentz will throw. Buying time to his left.
Bitch. Bitch. Bitch, I'm a key, motherfucker.
His guys will get the football back. And now out comes Houston. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. Six, seven, eight, nine, whatever it's going to take. It's a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Call it about a gain of three, and they'll be looking at a third and seven coming up.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on second down.
Hurry up, here we go. Green, 30.
Leopard! Leopard!
No, 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 no. Check. Patriot! Patriot!
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Surveying the field. And this is caught. It's pulled in by Gronkowski. And they pick up 25 as they convert on third.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or a takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. They've got to figure now. They're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try to bleed it out.
He'll get about three as he's brought down right around the 42. Tackle made that time by Brandon Graham.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Let's see if they can convert here on third and three.
Four down, four down.
All right, here we go.
Green, 39.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. Push his way up to about the 44 here. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down.
So many things go into making a good play on defense. In this situation, just not being blown out of the way was a big start, and then a nice tackle to finish things off.
44 on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. We'll call it a 42-yard punt, three on the return. And possession will switch here as this offense will come on deep in their own territory.
No, 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 check, Patriot, Patriot!
Down, sliding out of the pocket. Looking to hit Matthews, but it's intercepted. Picked off by the former first round pick, Kevin Johnson. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. And now out comes Houston. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a push it, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
Unfortunately, no gain on the play, and it's second down. So second and 10 here. They come out here in the eye. Second and 10. He's got Fuller. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route, and what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing, and they got it done.
So they're leading. They have possession of the football, and certainly this is where they just want to milk the clock.
Hurry up! Here we go. 319. 319.
And 58 is the mic. Go 58 to the mic. Bring it. Bring it.
Time running out here on the play clock. Out of the gun now on third down. Quickly to Gronkowski. That's gone. Yeah, brought down, but not before he was able to break the tackle, and the extra effort moves the sticks. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. To him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands, they can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
Check four, check four. Back down, Shelly, here we go. Hurry up, here we go.
Way down right around the 12. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down.
Well, big man with ball met bigger man on the other side of the line. A really nice play for the defense.
Defense second pass. They've got the nickel set out on third and six.
Watch him now, Barney. Barney.
Toss, and he's going to be stopped up, and the Eagles are going to go ahead and take another timeout. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. And this one is no good. He missed it, and this score will stay right where it is. So a bullet dodge there defensively. They surrender excellent field position on the kick return, but it winds up not costing them a thing.
And that's a tough sequence of events from an offensive perspective. The inability to get first downs leads to the field goal try, and the inability to cash that in leads to nothing on the scoreboard.
Philadelphia first. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside.
Watch it now, Barney! Barney! Detroit! Detroit! Set! Green, 39!
He'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. 16 seconds now on the clock.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Second down now after the incompletion. This one complete, left side to Green Beckham. A good pickup there, a 22. And he did exactly what they needed him to do, Charles. Got out of bounds. They have no timeouts.
And they knew that before the play even began. Still executed it. How many times have we seen it happen where you know it, yet a guy still looking for a timeout or trying to stay in bounds? He got it done.
Here we go now. Blue landing.
Back to throw. The ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. He was looking for Dorial Green Beckham, and now it's second down.
Well, that plays a statistic that's going to go on the defensive team stat sheet. Won't necessarily reflect in ours, right, the overall game sheet. But you and I know that they keep count on pressures, hits on quarterbacks, all those things, hoping to increase that throughout the game. And here we are in the fourth quarter, and they got a big one.
Yeah, it's such a close game, a very big one. Back to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Alshon Jeffrey, the intended receiver, and it's third down. And now the Texans are going to stop it as they signal for a timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. So still a full 10 yards to go here for the offense on third down.
Try
not.